Hello everyone, in this video session we are going to discuss the CSS attribute selectors. CSS attribute selectors. So first open the edit plus. Okay, for that attributes, let us suppose I am having an anchor tag and href is equal to, let us suppose I am going to add some Gmail. Okay, adding some any other link, whatever you want, you can add that. Okay. And in this I'm going to add some Gmail. Okay, this Gmail link I'm going to add in anchor tag. Okay, here, and I'm making it as Gmail, and just close out this anchor tag. Okay, now I'm going to make this styling HTML element with specific attributes. Here one of my attributes is href. So in anchor tag I may also have target. So target is equal to blank, like that I can use. So when I using this attribute, you already know that when I click over here, it will goes to the another link, right? So just make the control S. Okay, I'm going to save this as selector css.html, save. Okay, now here see, you already had a link like this. So now I am going to styling this in this way: anchor tag with attribute target. So target, wherever you get that target, first I need to write this in style format. That is style, right? Here in this style, I'm going to add the style. So anchor tag is in target. Okay, target. Now in target, I'm going to write the code over here. Just add a background color. Background color. So background color might be yellow. I'm going to add background color yellow. I'm going to add. Now see, for every anchor tag, wherever you get a target like this link, just save it and open wherever it is in HP desktop, and just open here. So you get a Gmail with a background color yellow. Right, in this way you will get. Let us suppose I am going to take another anchor tag that is regarding a Facebook anchor tag. href is equal to some hash fb and fb, and I am going to close this anchor tag. I am having another anchor tag, just see here. But did it get a yellow color as background? No. Why? Because only Gmail is containing the attribute target. Okay. It is also containing the target. But self. Okay. So for that type of values, now see here. Even it is having a target attribute, so it is also get a background color yellow. So we also can make it equivalent to the value. So I just want to give this background color only to the blank links. Okay, then just to refresh the page and see the changes you observe. See, Gmail is only the blank target. That is the reason it is only getting a yellow color as background. Okay, right? And this is not the blank, this is self. That is the reason it is not accessing the yellow color. okay, you can access this with another, like a target. Target is equal to value. Value is self you can keep. To this self, you can add the content here. The same like background color, something else you can add red color. You can add red color to the self. Now just see the change. Okay. Now just see the change. Target spelling is wrong. Target is equal to self. Just write in a equivalent and you get the red color over here. In this way it is going to access. Even we can equivalent with a value. Selector is used to select any element with an attribute. With a specific word also we can make it equivalent. Let us suppose I am having my in paragraph I'm having a title attribute. Title is equal to let us suppose summer flower, okay, and summer flower, and I'm having another paragraph that is with the title flowers, and that is flowers, and I'm going to close this para, and I'm having another para with the title new flower, new flower. Just close this. Title is equal to new flower, and just type here the new flower and just close the para. So wherever the title contains the flowers, only to that style this will be applicable. So this is an paragraph element, and the attribute is title, title, and similar equivalent to the value of flower, right? So equivalent to the flower, then only this word will specify and the style belongs to here with the border I am giving 5 pixels double red. In red color, I am going to give the border. See, here P is the title. Wherever the title, at least it contains a flower. In paragraph, see where the flower is containing, only at the paragraph title, only at the paragraph new flower title. Why does not a flower? Because S is the extra letter there over here. So it will only check the complete name over. So the first para and the third para with the title new flower and summer flower will only displayed in a border. So just save it and see the output here. Now you observe, only these two will get the border. That means the properties will be applicable only to this, right? In the same way, you can also use for flowers. If you use flowers, only to the P title only it will be applicable. So just see here, if it is in a flowers, it is different only to that. Now you can also use the attribute like this. In place of hyphen, you can also use the or symbol. Okay. That means title or equal to flower. That means it will sense that wherever if you can get the color of flowers here, that will be displayed. Okay, see here, flower is containing it, both the paragraphs, right? So OR symbol will intimate that the clause stop or followed by the hyphen class will get the changes. See here, came nothing to, that means it is completely set the clause top. Okay, the value top will be there completely. Let us suppose if I am having another para with the title name only flower, I am just deleting this only flower. Now see, only to the first it will get. So that means the complete name it needs to be verified. If the target is flower over here, the title name could also be completely flower, not as new or something else, right? This is about the or. And you can also use the power symbol. You can also use the power symbol. That is, in place here, just use the like this. This means what? The selector is used to select elements whose attribute value belongs with a specified value. If it is belongs with only this flower, see, flower bouquet. Okay, this is started with the flower, and this isn't started. This is also isn't started. So P title will be get to only P1, right? So just see over here, only to the one it will get. And you can also make, you can start with flower garden. Flower garden, this is also started with flower, this is also started. So it will only check which letter it will started with. If it is started with flower and flower, then only to that paragraphs that applications will be applied. So here flower is started with how many paras? Only two paras, that is flower bouquet and flower garden, right? So only to this paragraph this will be applicable. See, only to this paragraphs. In this way we can use the hyphen, and even we can use the dollar value. Even we can use the dollar value. What is the use of this dollar value? What it resembles? Okay, dollar value here resembles that select elements whose attribute value ends with, whose attribute value ends with. Here flower ends with which one? Only the third para, right? That is new flower, right? So just save it and see the output. Only to the last para it is getting, that means it is only ended with flower, right? Now coming to the another one, that is the arsenic. Okay, what is the mean of this? It is to select the elements whose attribute value contain a specific value. Okay, whose attribute value contains a specific value. Let us suppose if it is having a flaw, if at least it contains only a flaw, flaw will be contained in each and everything. So just observe here, you can get to all the paragraphs. At least it needs to contain a flaw in each and every title. In each and every title. See here. Here flaw is there. Here flaw is there. And here flaw is there. Right? Nothing is there. Garden. Garden. G-A-R is there only in second one. So use only G-A-R over here. And now just save it and see. Only second one will having the G-A-R. So only second one will get it. Okay, in this way we can style the forms. Even we can style, in this way we are going to style the attributes. Okay, thank you for watching this video, and for more videos please subscribe to our channel Ratan IT.